we flew into Vietnam and lit at Benoit, Consonute Air Force Base in Benoit, and then we were assigned to a camp called Bearcat, and I went there, and your first 30 days in country were to fill sandbags, and that's what we did every day, was fill sandbags until I this colonel pulled me away that one day because I was taking all these pictures, and he asked me to go to work for him as a combat photographer, and that's where I got started. And then after that, I flew every day, and we flew every day because there was somewhere in South Vietnam in our 214th Combat Aviation Brigade headquarters and headquarters company that somebody crashed a helicopter, and we had to go photograph that helicopter. And 90% of the time it was a hot LZ, so we had to wait for the Marines or the 9th Division or somebody to protect that LZ so we could land a helicopter to go in there and investigate that accident and see what caused it. And we spent, might have spent a couple of hours there, but they had to secure the area. And lots of times it was what they called the hot LZ, so we had to stay there because we couldn't get out. But most of the time, that's basically what I did every day. We just flew and went to a helicopter accident every day. I mean, there was something every day. And one of my biggest ones was that I remember that we had three helicopters collide in midair and end up killing. Of course, everybody was deceased, but it was one of my biggest memories that I can remember. I was in country for 1 year. I got there on September 2nd of 1967, and I left on September 2nd of 1968. And the day we left, we couldn't take off because the VC were bombing the runway in Benoit. And the pilot asked everybody on there, there was like 400 people on that airplane. And the pilot says, well, what do you guys think? And they said, let's go. And we went. And luckily we made it. There was nobody said anything for a long time after we got in there. But once we were off and gone, man. When I came home, it was, everybody was protesting. It was a different deal. When I came home, I lit in Pierre, South Dakota, and I didn't tell anybody I was coming home. And I was pretty proud. I had my Army uniform on and my duffel bag, and I landed out here, and I walked all the way from the airport out to the truck bypass and all the way out to the Forehand, because I lived in Blount, which is not very far from here. And finally, one of the guys that I knew, or was a friend of my dad, recognized me, and he stopped and picked me up. Otherwise, nobody would pick you up. No, I don't think as far as changed me any, I don't think so, no. That's kind of I don't know. I just think we I don't know. No, I don't. I don't know. I don't think so. Well, I know we lost 58,000 people over there. And I don't think that was right, but. Well, you know, Vietnam it's a nice country. It's a beautiful country. But I mean, the war ruined it. And, you know, before the Tet Offensive, Vietnam was, you know, like going on a, you know, on weekends, we'd just go to Saigon or, you know, or somewhere and drink our beer and have a good time. And then the Tet Offensive happened. And after that, then there was no more there. But there was people fighting every day in different parts of Vietnam that you know, that weren't affecting us. But, you know, the Northern High Corps and up by Way and Phu Bai and, you know, up in that Cameron Bay. And then that was a different war up there than we were in South Country. So, you know, we didn't see all that. But at night when we were flying over the trail, we were taking pictures of the VC movement. So we had flash bulbs and we were flying in a Charlie model, which is a UH-1C, and we had flash bulbs on both sides about the size of a 50 gallon barrel, you know, or bigger, and then we used those to take pictures of the movement of the VC so they knew where the VC, you know, what they were carrying and what they were doing and how much ammunition they had and all that. And the VC could hear a helicopter coming, but they didn't know where it was at, you know, because the pilots all had night vision. And I never had any night vision. I just sat back there when the pilots say now. I hit two buttons and both flash bulbs went off and I took pictures. And then I'd climb out on the wings and crank the cameras and get ready for the next one, you know. And we did that a lot of nights. And then I did pictures of the VC movement out of a bird dog, which is a kind of like a Piper Cub, only it's a more horsepower. And we did a lot of pictures with that during the day. But mostly I did aircraft accidents. Took a lot of pictures.